Welcome to HI Maths for Graduates. In the previous video, we have seen that for the set A containing 3 elements, we have formed a group G containing all the permutations. Okay, so this is a group containing all the permutations for the set A. So this is known as permutation group. Okay. Now I will tell you what is the difference between permutation group and symmetric group. Okay, now let us first see what is the definition of permutation group. In permutation group, a group formed from the permutations of any set, for example here I have taken A, a group formed from the permutation of any set A is known as permutation group. Okay, now in symmetric group, a group formed from all the permutations of any set A is known as symmetric group. So this is the only difference between permutation group and symmetric group. Now let us understand with an example. For this set A, G is a group formed by all the permutations. So this group is symmetric group. This is symmetric group. Okay. Now, from the definition, I can say that every symmetric group is a permutation group but every permutation group is not symmetric. Okay, now let us see an example. Let us form a group containing these 3 permutations. This one, this one, this one. Okay. This group G is a permutation group, but not symmetric. Okay. Now, let us understand what is symmetric group and how do we denote it. It is denoted by SN. And S represents symmetric and N represents that this symmetric group contains permutations of a set having N elements. That means cardinality of that set A is N. Okay, now let us know some facts. Symmetric group SN has factorial N elements. Okay. Now, symmetric group SN, if N greater than or equal to 3, then SN is non-abelian group. Okay. Now, for this particular example, A has 3 elements, so and this group G contains all the permutations, so this group G is nothing but S3 because there are three elements in this set A. Okay, so this is symmetric group S3. Now let us know a result that S3 symmetric to S3 is isomorphic to dihedral group D3. Okay, now let us form a Kelly table for S3. Okay, S3 is given by so this is S3. Okay, now let us call this element as E because it is an identity element, and this is as F1, F2, F3, F4 and F5. Okay, now let us form Kelly table. E, F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, E, F1, F2, F3, F4 and F5. Identity, composition with the identity will be same elements E, F1, F2, F3, F4 and F5, and this will be F1, 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 F2, F1, F3, F1, F4, F1, F5, and this will be F2, F2, F1, F2, 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 F3, F2, F4, F2, F5, F3, F3, F1, F3, F2, F3, 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 F4, and F3, F5, and so on. Now let us find these elements. Okay. F1, 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 F2, F1, F3, F1, F4, and F1. F5. Okay, now writing these elements, let us multiply this. Okay, F1, F1, this will be equals to 1 2 3. Okay, 1 is mapping to 1 here, and here 1 is mapping to 1, so this will be 1. 2 is mapping to 3 here, and 3 is mapping to 2 here, so it will be 2. 3 is mapping to 2, and 2 is mapping to 3, so this will be 3. Okay, and this equals to what? Identity I. Now here for F1, F2, 1 is mapping to 3 and 3 is mapping to 2, so it will be 2. 2 is mapping to 2 and 2 is mapping to 3, so it will be 3. 3 is mapping to 1 and 1 is mapping to 1, so it will be 1. Okay, and this is what? 2, this is F4. Okay, now for here, for F1, F3, 1 is mapping to 2 and 2 is mapping to 3, so this is 3. 2 is mapping to 1 and 1 is mapping to 1, so it will be 1. 3 is mapping to 3 and 3 is mapping to 2, so it will be 2. And this is what? This is F5. Okay, now for F1, F4, 1 is mapping to 2 and 2 is mapping to 3, so it will be 3. 2 is mapping to 3 and 3 is mapping to 2, so it will be 2. 3 is mapping to 1 and 1 is mapping to 1, so it will be 1. And this is F2. Now for F1, F5, 1 is mapping to 3 and 3 is mapping to 2, so it will be 2. 1 is mapping, 2 is mapping to 1 and 1 is mapping to 1, so it will be 1. 3 is mapping to 2 and 2 is mapping to 3, so it will be 3. And this is what? This is F3. Okay, Now similarly, we can find the product for F2, F1, F2, 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 F3, F2, F4, and F2, F5, and so on, okay? So these are the product of the remaining elements. Now putting this value into the Kelly table, okay? So F1 into F1, F1 into F1 is E, and F1, F2 is F4, F1, F3 is F5, and F1, F4 is F2, and F1, F5 is F3. So this is the complete Kelly table. Now you can see that F1, F3 is not equal to F3, F1. That means S3 is non-abelian group. Okay, so this is the end of the video. In the next video, you will see more important result related to this group, and you will see what is S4 group. Okay, thank you. Thanks for watching.